dialogue. And I would now like to invite Irma Erlingsdóttir, who is director of RIKK and the guest program, to give us an inaugural address.
Dear all, the word pandemic was used no less than 3 times by Angela Davis in her address at the 2019 Me Too conference in Reykjavík to refer to the gender-based violence that kills or threatens the lives of women and the vulnerable all over the world. When a systemic malaise is no longer a metaphor in a time of a medical pandemic, language speaks to the power of the horror inflicted upon millions. In the elusive area between sexual harassment and abuse as a law and order problem, and gender-based violence as a systemic form of social and cultural despair, the answer to what approach would be most effective in its correction or eradication is not easy to identify. Yet, one of the optimistic ventures that the Me Too movement has prompted and brought to the fore is the idea of alternative justice systems that lie outside such carceral outside the carceral and address the system and the individual together. Scrutinizing such alternative justice systems is at the center of our conference today. It promises to be a highly relevant platform to explore ways to improve our efforts in achieving gender justice. I want to second Prime Minister Katrin Jakobsdóttir, thanks to all who made this conference and the Reykjavík dialogue possible, the speakers and different contributors from all over the world, the advisory committee, the Prime Minister's office, and from our RIKK Institute, research specialist Gidi Chandra, as well as Elin Björk Johansdóttir, a project manager for the event, who has been instrumental in pulling all this together. In closing, allow me to bring up an urgent matter that has a direct bearing on the issues discussed at the Reykjavík dialogue. Given the rapid deterioration of the situation in Afghanistan, with the Taliban regaining power, the lives of Afghan women who have worked hard to advance women and girls' rights in the country are in serious danger. This includes women working for NGOs, civil society, political leaders, and UN staff. I urge the Reykjavík dialogue to produce a joint statement aimed at protecting the lives of women in Afghanistan who are under serious threat, calling on governments in different areas of the world to take action to alleviate what is rapidly becoming a humanitarian disaster. I wish us all a fruitful Reykjavík dialogue. Thanks.